Hello, this is Dr. Eric Bricker, and thank you for watching A Healthcare Z. Today we're going to be discussing the 10 largest pharmaceutical companies. Now, if we're going to discuss healthcare finance in general, then we need to know the players specifically. And there is probably no better place to know the players than in the world of pharmaceuticals. So, there's a lot of numbers here and a lot of words, so we're going to go over this in detail. Okay, first up, the largest pharmaceutical company in the world is Pfizer. It has $54 billion a year in revenue. Its largest selling drugs are Prevnar, which is a vaccine for pneumococcal pneumonia, and it has $5.8 billion of sales. This is all for 2018. Lyrica, which is a pill that's taken for neuropathy, oftentimes diabetic neuropathy or nerve pain. It had $5 billion of sales in 2018. Eliquis, which had $3.4 billion in sales, is a blood thinner replacement for like Coumadin or Warfarin, oftentimes used in AFib or for blood clots in the legs, called a DVT. And then lastly, we have Enbrel at $2 billion. And of course, many of you know Enbrel because it's one of the major competing drugs for Humira, which is used for rheumatoid arthritis. Okay, next up we have Novartis. Now, Novartis is actually based in Switzerland, not in America. It has $52 billion of sales. Its largest selling drug is Gilenya, which is $3.3 billion. It's used to treat multiple sclerosis. Next up, we have Cosentyx, which is $3 billion, and that's used to treat psoriatic arthritis and also ankylosing spondylitis. Those are kind of cousins of rheumatoid arthritis. It's an injection medication. And Lucentis, so this is used for diabetic macular edema. It's also used for macular degeneration, so it's actually injected in the eye. Okay, next up we have, oh, by the way, Lucentis is actually not going to show up in your pharmacy claims, it's going to show up in your medical claims. And as we go out through the rest of these medications, I'm going to tell you which ones are actually not going to show up in your pharmacy claims, but rather in your medical claims. So a lot of your pharmacy spend is hiding in your medical claims, and I'm going to go over that as well. Okay, next up we have Roche, also based in Switzerland. They have $46 billion a year in sales. Their largest selling medication is Herceptin. It's an infusion for breast cancer, $7 billion in sales. You can see I there for infusion, because, again, it's going to show up in your medical claims. Next up is Avastin, another infusion medication used to treat cancer, oftentimes metastatic cancer, $6.8 billion in sales. Again, will show up on your medical claims, not your pharmacy claims. Last up is Rituxan. Finally, another medication that's going to show up in your medical claims, not in your pharmacy claims, because it's an infusion medication. It's used to treat multiple types of leukemia, lymphoma, and it's also actually used to treat rheumatoid arthritis as well, an infusion that does that, at $6.8 billion in sales. Okay, number four, J&J, that's Johnson & Johnson, based in New Jersey, $41 billion in sales. Its number one selling medication is Remicade. That's an infusion medication for Crohn's disease, and again, can actually be used for rheumatoid arthritis as well, $6 billion in sales. Stelara is also an infusion medication, again, can be used for Crohn's disease as well, $5 billion in sales. It's injections after the initial infusion, so it's kind of a combination of the two. And Xarelto, $2.5 billion in sales. That is a competitor to Eliquis. It is a Coumadin warfarin replacement as a blood thinner. Okay, next up we have Sanofi. Sanofi is a French company. Sanofi has $39 billion in sales. Its largest selling medication, as many of you are aware, is Lantus, the long-acting insulin, at $4.7 billion in sales. Of course, Lantus is very controversial because of the great expense for insulin and how the price of insulin has gone up so much. They also make Plavix, which is a blood thinner pill, oftentimes given for people after heart attacks and after they've had stents placed, and also Lovenox, another blood thinner medication. Okay, next up we have Merck, based in the United States, $38 billion in sales. They have Keytruda, which is an infusion medication used also to treat cancer. It is oftentimes used to treat myeloma, at $7.2 billion in sales. Keytruda's sales have really been skyrocketing. It was like only half as much last year in 2017 and $7.2 billion in 2018. Januvia is a pill for diabetes at $6 billion. It's actually come down somewhat. It used to be higher in previous years. And Gardasil, which is an injection, again, it's going to show up in your medical claims, not in your pharmacy claims, typically injected in the doctor's office, and this is a vaccine for HPV infection, okay, and it's at $12.3 billion. Okay, next up, we have, $2.3 billion, said the wrong thing. Okay, next up, number seven, AbbVie, which is at $33 billion in sales. And AbbVie is kind of a one-trick pony, so to speak, in that they're the makers of Humira, which is the largest selling medication in the world, the injection medication that's used for rheumatoid arthritis and also for Crohn's disease as well. You can see $20 billion in sales. You can see like two-thirds of AbbVie's sales are just from one medication. So it's almost like the exact opposite of like Novartis and Pfizer are probably two of the most diversified pharmaceutical companies where you can see, even though they have these blockbuster medications, they still make up a relatively small percentage of their overall revenue, whereas for AbbVie, it's highly concentrated in the Humira. And then last up, just to summarize and round out the top 10, we have Amgen at $24 billion. GlaxoSmithKline, or otherwise known as GSK, at $23 billion, and Bristol-Myers Squibb at approximately $23 billion as well. So there you have it, the 10 largest pharmaceutical companies in the world, along with the main drivers of their revenue in terms of medications. And again, note that some of them are pills that will show up in your pharmacy spend and injections that will show up in your pharmacy spend, but many of them are also infusions that are only going to show up in your medical spend. And that's my point for today. Thank you for watching A Healthcare Z.